Thanks, Jim. We're just going to have a word with the fella who's fronting up to Tyson Fury tonight. Interesting fella. Marcel Zeller is his name. This is his dressing room. It's only the second time he's ever been to Britain. The first time he's fought here, but Scottish fans in particular will be very interested in this guy. There he is, the Highlander. Tell us about this kilt action, Marcel.
Yeah, well, my father was... I never met him. He died when I was... Small boy, a few months. And, yeah, that's why I wear the kilt.
He was Scottish.
One reason.
Yeah, he was Scottish, and this is your tribute.
Yeah, sure. And my first trainer for the first fights was half Scottish. His father was in the Scottish Army. And we thought about what can we do about for the audience. The audience has to remember me.
Well, they can't.
But I saw him one time with the kilt. And I told him, give me a kilt, and I fight with a kilt. Yeah, that's the story.
Now, be honest, do a little bit of shadow boxing for us. You can move okay in that, can you? Is that not a silly question? Yeah?
Have to talk with you now, or well, no?
Just don't hit me, you know, just, yeah.
KO.
But the kilt feels okay. The kilt feels okay, it's
yeah, you know. It feels confident.
Okay.
You have to ask you.
I know. Yeah, oh, my wife, yeah.
Skirts
I feel confident.
it's a skirt, you know? It's got a skirt, a kilt, but it's a skirt. You have to ask your woman.
I'm not going to ask you what's underneath it. What I am going to ask you is, can you win tonight?
A real Scottish doesn't wear anything under his skirt.
That's why I wasn't going to ask you.
Okay.
Final question.
Yeah.
Seriously, can you win tonight?
Sure. I'm a knockouter. 21 wins. 21, by the way, of knockout. I can, if I win, just one guy goes with me over the rounds. When I win, I knock him out, or I lose. But I don't think about this.
Well, good luck.
Thank you.
To the Highlander.
Thank you.
There you go, Jim. Some character.
Absolutely, Gabriel. There'd be one or two people out there who Gabriel's interview who'd wish he'd landed that left hook, I have to say.
That's right. I love that. As soon as he came out in, or as soon as he came back at Gabriel, do you notice how quickly he got good,
he got
good footwork?
Yeah.
He moved back like a bullet. But that was very funny. Very funny. Yeah.
And a very, very confident fella. You've never fought in a kilt, have you?
Never fought in a kilt. No. But
I've seen some of your get-ups and they've been right.
I was going to say, they've been a bit close.
They're all right.
They've been close.
They're my design.
Split
my design.
With
the
leg
that's
and all of that sort of
that's
stuff.
That's it. You look good. You fight good.
All right.
That's what I say. But no, like I say, he's been very happy, very confident.
Lovely.
You know, looking forward to it.
Okay, let me just remind you, it's the Big Fight Live. We are in Wigan and we're looking ahead for the British lightweight title fight coming up in, well, what will it be? Around about half an hour's time, probably. Manchester man John Murray defending the title he won in his last fight. He has a big following here tonight. His opponent is the Scot Lee McAllister. McAllister, 26. He has serious ambitions to take the belt back to Aberdeen, and that's coming up after we have seen Tyson Fury in action against the German Highlander. Let's rejoin our MC, Thomas Treiber.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the ring from Germany, Marcel the Highlander Zeller.
Thought the Highlander might have come in to Braveheart or the Proclaimers or something, but no, it's Guns N' Roses. Pretty big over in Germany, and Marcel Zeller, all 16 stone eight of him. He is, as he told Gabriel, a knockout artist. And he's quite prepared to engage a few people in the crowd, let them know he's here and that he means business. He might not have beaten top-class opposition, but he's got 21 wins and he's knocked out 20, so that tells its own story. From Karlsruhe in Germany, 35 years old. Is he going to ruin the story of Tyson Fury?
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the ring from Manchester, Tyson Fury.
My start looking at what you might get, and start being thankful for what you do get. Let's give it to him, baby.
And here's Big Tyson, all 6'9" of him. Here's one for students of the sport. Facially, doesn't he look a bit like Jack Doyle, the great Irish heavyweight of the 1930s? He can certainly bang, and he can box a bit. ABA super heavyweight champion, and he says destined to become world champion. Well, time will tell. It's the learning curve for now, and he's got a dangerous man in the opposite corner.
Ladies and gentlemen, the action continues with a special attraction in the heavyweight division, scheduled for 6 rounds. Introducing to you first, to my left in the blue corner, he comes to the ring tonight wearing a kilt with Royal Stuart tartan and weighed in at 16 stone, 8 pounds, 8 ounces. A native of Germany, he brings with him a professional record of 21 wins, 3 losses, with 20 of his 21 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Marcel the Highlander Zeller. And his opponent in the red corner, he's wearing black trunks with white lettering and weighed in at 18 stone, 1 pound. Hailing from Manchester, he was the ABA Senior Super Heavyweight Champion of 2008 and now is a professional. He has a professional record of 1 win, no losses, with that win coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Tyson Fury.
The big man's getting a bit of a following.
And ladies and gentlemen, your referee in charge is Mr. Howard Foster.
Tyson. Okay, lads, you both know the rules. Keep it clean, break straight away when told. Both of you watch your heads. Good luck to you both. Touch gloves. Touch gloves. Good luck, lads.
Well, I don't doubt that it's happened somewhere before, but in my recollection, that's the first time I've heard a master of ceremonies saying he comes to the ring wearing a kilt, but he has done. That's Marcel Zeller.
He's out. Round one.
And Tyson Fury, with one big knockout win, now goes looking for another one. Tall fellow Fury needs to keep his concentration. Zeller will be dangerous in the early stages.
Rick, stop boxing! Stop boxing! Let him go!
He's got this sort of street fighter style, Zeller. Tyson Fury will know all about that one. A few from his community, Dad included, who could do a bit on the cobbles.
I'd like to see a much more cautious approach from Fury in the first round, at least, because, you know, Zeller's going to come swinging and winging for him. Just needs to be just a little bit cautious. He's got the height, he's got the reach.
Oh, that's a good right hand. Zeller felt that one. Really good quality shot. Come on, let's have a bit more. Well, I think Tyson will probably oblige, but he can't afford to get careless. That's a good quality uppercut. Really good right hand from Fury. And he senses that he might be able to end his man here in the first. That's a terrific right uppercut. Well, Zeller is hardly fleet of foot. He's not slipping anything. And he almost walked into another vicious uppercut there.
Well, he's done well so far, Zeller, to stand up to this attack, because Fury's putting everything into every punch and catching him quite cleanly.
Big uppercut again. employs that right hand with great effect.
Zeller still on his feet. You know, we've seen guys fall over from lesser punches.
Well, there's only so many he can take, surely. Zeller doing that. He's doing no more than just covering up now.
He's hurt, make no mistake about that. The body shots and the head shots, everything's hurting. He's keeping his defence, he's keeping his composure.
Fury, incidentally, looks very much physically better than he did on his debut. He came back from honeymoon on that occasion, went in at 18 stone 9, this time 18 stone 1, and he looks a far fitter man. This is the danger shot, that swinging overhand right from Zeller.
Well, he'll need to be, Fury, he'll need to be on his game because, you know, this guy hasn't fallen over or looked to take the easy way out.
Another terrific uppercut from Fury, but Zeller takes it again.
Then back up to
big opening round for Tyson Fury. Uppercuts like that, well, many a fighter would have gone down to that. Zeller is a strong man and still in there. The man with the big knockout record, 20 knockout wins in his 21 victories against 3 defeats. You heard him himself before the fight, he said, either I knock you out or I lose.
I like Fury when he uses the jab. Don't see too many heavyweights in this day using that jab. Better when he uses it and puts the right hand through. But, you know, he works the body really well as well for a big, big man as he is.
Zeller, incidentally, while you were at the advertising break, was getting one or two rather interesting words in his corner, which I can tell you were amusing, but possibly better not be repeated verbatim. Suffice to say that the opening shot was, well, you lost the war and you are losing this as well. But it was a bit, he said a little bit more than that.
First blood to Fury, as you'd imagine. Zeller's nose is bleeding now.
There was a lot of laughter from those who heard what was said, incidentally. Even a wry smile from Zeller. Tyson is putting a lot into these. And Zeller's suggesting he's not being hurt. Fury's just got to be careful that he doesn't punch himself out.
Absolutely. You know, he's got a game Zeller in front of him. Very game indeed.
A lot of fighters in the early stages of their careers go for people who are just pushovers. And this fella, Zeller, he's not a pretty fighter. Let's not kid ourselves, but he can punch. And he's still there. Big words talked about for Tyson Fury. And in a sense, by saying those sort of things, he puts himself under pressure to deliver and under pressure to look spectacular. He went looking for that first round win and his work rate has notably slowed here in the second.
Absolutely, because he's put so much into the opening rounds and into this round. Zeller's still there. Zeller's got one chance of winning, and that's that big overhand right that he likes to swing.
Well, it's almost, he almost sends a telegram before it's delivered, doesn't he? It's sort of, here it comes, mate. Oh, that's a good shot. What a shake of the head. Those are big punches from Fury. Zeller takes them all. And here comes some more. There's something a bit Foreman-esque, isn't there, about the way he wings in those hooks and uppercuts. Good attack from Fury in the closing seconds of that second round, and when he's back on the ropes there, Zeller is being looked at very closely by referee Howard Foster, and he's been told by his own corner men between rounds, don't just lie on the ropes, because as you do so, the referee's looking and he will see it. Saying just before the interval there, that advertising break, Duke, that Tyson Fury There's something a bit foreman-ish the way he swings those big damaging hooks and uppercuts.
Absolutely. He puts everything into every punch when he starts to tee off. It will take its toll if he can't maintain it.
Oh, it's a good left hand. It's all over, I think. No, it's not. No, he's just indicated timeout. There's a low blow. There's a low blow. He's in a bit of a mess. I hope that there is something under that kilt. If not, it would be really damaging. I think he is wearing an abdominal protector. Let's hope so. Otherwise, it could be something which lives with him for some time. Yes. Even as it is, he's in a lot of pain.
He's got a protector on. The referee will give him time to get over. It was a slightly low blow, but it was the power that was delivered with it.
Let's have a look again there. There's the low one. There may have been another one as well on the blind side. And he's being given time by Howard Foster. In theory, he can have 5 minutes, can't he?
Absolutely.
He's taken away saying, I'm OK. Well, to be honest, I think you'd probably say, have a bit more time, mate, but he wants to get on with it. He's a hard guy, Marcel Zeller.
He certainly is.
There are a few Scottish flags, incidentally, in the crowd. Of course, they're here to fight to support Lee McAllister, who's fighting later on. But they were giving Marcel Zeller, kilt and all, plenty of cheers when he came into the ring. He's been told by his corner that he's got to roll in, got to get into range, and not just lie back on the ropes. Easier said than done.
If Fury can catch him with one of the uppercuts that he throws, the right uppercut in particular, which he throws with a lot of venom, the fight will be over.
Fury just looking for his opportunity, content to jab his way in and then land clubbing body shots like that. That was a big right hand, that one, which hammered into the ribcage.
Fury doing a better job in this round of keeping his hands up. It just nearly stopped a right hand there. Got to keep the hands up, chin down, breathing heavily. Fury put a lot of effort in.
Bit of an idiosyncrasy. He took a right hand there as well. There's an idiosyncrasy as he just pulls at the waistband of his shorts and his protector, Tyson Fury, and as he does so, just leaves himself open to those overhand rights. That's a good shot. Kilt came up a bit there. Now the referee's got to be having a look here. Howard Foster is poised. He's saying to Zeller, you've got to do something, you've got to throw. Bravely, the German is still there and still trying to land. Oh, there's the uppercut again, Duke.
That hurt. That really hurt. He will have to throw back. The referee will stop this fight. Make no mistake, if these punches are not answered.
Zeller complaining that was low, and it's been stopped. It's been stopped by the referee, and he is furious about that. He dropped his gloves because he said it was a low blow. And he is furious about that. He's a proud guy, Marcel Zeller. He didn't want it to be ended there. He thought he'd still got more to offer. But in the third round, the fight is over. And Tyson has won. Tyson Fury has won for a second time. And big applause from the crowd for Marcel Zeller, who really made a fight of it. But the young Tyro registers another victory.
Well, he did a good job. You know, he backs him up, he gets both hands working, he caught him flush, stepped across, looked for the angle to come back with another punch, didn't quite see it, got straight back to the jab.
Well, Howard Foster was looking here. Now, there's that one which was borderline low, and then there's another one after that which comes in which was low there. That's when the gloves came down, and he said, oh, come on, what's going on? And then, with one more blow landed, the fight is all over. Premature or correct?
Correct.
Well, that's from Duke McKenzie, and there's a celebrating 20-year-old Tyson Fury from near Manchester, and he is victorious once more. How good is he?
We won't know for several years to come.
He's going to be on a steep learning curve. He says that he wants to go looking for a British title next year when he's 21. Who knows? But for now, it's 2 out of 2 for the big fella, Tyson Fury.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the official time. 2:50 of round number 3. Our referee in charge, Howard Foster, stops the contest. Your winner, Tyson Fury.
Well, he looked Foreman-esque, according to John Rawling, but that is a great learning fight and a really tough one as well, actually, for just his second professional fight for Tyson Fury.
And ladies and gentlemen,
our British lightweight title fight is coming up very shortly. When you rejoin us, we'll be talking to Mr. Fury. Yeah, back with us in Wigan and back with us with Tyson Fury. 2 wins out of 2, but a great learning fight for you, that one.
Yeah, good learning fight. Kid had 20 knockouts out of 21 wins, 3 losses. So I don't know any heavyweights in the world who started off with opponents like that. I made to send shockwaves around the world, and I think I've done that tonight.
And he was a very, very tough fella. He was upset when it ended. Would you have liked to have had a bit more action in there?
I think the referee made the right decision because he was getting punch. He was getting shook up with every punch I was hitting him with. He was crippling with the body shots. I don't know what the referee was up to, but I thought I hit him smack under the rib cage with one of them ups, and he said it was low. I think he could have been finished in that round, but got a bit more experience out. And I hope everyone who comes to support me and everyone watching me like my performance.
You've got a good variety of punches in your locker, haven't you?
Yes, this is just a chip off the iceberg, though. I had 4 weeks to get fit for this fight, and just imagine having 20 years of not training right or eating right, and 4 weeks of eating right and training right, and this is what shape I'm in. Imagine what will be like after 3 years of eating and training right.
And you're convinced you're going to be British champion, what, this year even, perhaps?
Oh, yeah, this year, without a doubt. It's all up to Mick anyway. But if the fighters out there will fight me, then I'm willing.
Okay.
Just got to get a bit fitter, and I'm always learning, never stop learning.
Well, I don't know if you've seen any videos or pictures of a fighter called George Foreman in his prime, but that's what our commentators were comparing you to tonight. That's high praise.
Well, George Foreman's one of my superheroes, so to be compared to him is just an astonishment, really.
Listen, that's a really good effort, and perhaps you can go back and have something to eat now. Let yourself go a bit, because I know you worked very hard over Christmas and sort of trained all the way through, didn't you?
Yeah, well, I didn't really have no rest. I sacrificed Christmas for this fight, but I can be a lot fitter and I can learn a lot more. But it's just a learning fight, but it's okay fighting Latvians and things. He's had 1-4, lost 15,
sure.
And had not been knocked out 7 times. This kid had come to fight, he'd come to win, and he's a big banger. So imagine what I can be like against when I've had 7 or 8 or 10 fights.
Absolutely.
Even.
We look forward to seeing him all. Very well done. Let's have a quick word with Mick Hennessy, your promoter. He's making rapid progress, isn't he, this fella? And you're convinced he's going to have a British championship belt around him before the end of the year?
Well, I'm going to take it fight by fight, Jim. It's hard holding Tyson back because he wants to fight everyone now. But you just see what he's done now. How many fighters in their career take on someone like that in their second pro fight? Tyson Fury is the best prospect in world boxing, and he is going to shake up the heavyweight division like it hasn't been shaken up. And we're going to put him in learning fights, great learning fights now, and he's going to be a phenomenon in the heavyweight division.
It's a terrific start to his career. Well done.
Thanks, Jim.
Well done, Tyson. Good lad. OK, let's get the considered verdict then of John Paxton and Barry McGill. And John, sitting with you down here.
Yes.
I mean, you were really, really enthusiastic about what you saw there from Tyson Fury.
I was. A great learning fight to start. He was throwing every punch in the book, from the uppercuts to the body shots. Great, 2 out of 2. The only way is up. I'm very excited about the prospect.
And looking at the fight, there was a good variety of punches.
Yeah.
Those body shots were fantastic.
Yeah. I think, let's be honest, I think Zeller's record flatters him a little bit. Let's not be foolish about it. But you've got to look at this young kid in his second fight. This shows you the courage they have and the confidence they have in his ability to take on a guy like that with 21 or 20 knockouts. I think it's what we're seeing is basically a variety of punches here. What I like about him too is his adjustment. He steps back very well, he pulls in those uppercuts, he picks his shots well, he's got naturally fast hands, he switches to the body and brings those shots in. And you don't see heavyweights in their second pro fight stepping to the side. And he stepped back and uppercut there, round the side with the shot. So he's got a lovely variety of shots, he places them well. And I think also those body shots that hit him on the lifted his kilt, I think the kilt actually over sort of accentuated those, and they weren't as bad as they were made out to be. But the finish was good. He just
poured punches on, ripped it through, and the referee was right. Hard Foster was right.
Yeah, that's a low one there.
Yeah, but he hit him on top of the cup, and I think the.
I hope he had something substantial between him.
I think I saw that he did have, yes. He did have a cup protector on, but it was the right thing to do. He was going to get knocked out, the guy. Sooner or later, you know. Very impressive.
Any complaints about the stoppage?
No complaints. He was a gutsy kid, you know, but there was only one winner tonight. Only one winner in Tyson Fury.
Cheers, John.